بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أبنائي الأعزاء، طلاب الصف الأول الثانوي، وطبعا أنتوا بالنسبة لكم تجربة جديدة، حتة التابلت وحتة الكتاب والأوبن بوك والكلام ده كله، لكن هي تجربة جميلة وتجربة لذيذة وحنستفيد منها كلنا إن شاء الله بإذن الله. والمهم إن إحنا عايزين نتعلم، والمهم إن إحنا نستفيد من فائدة التعليم اللي إحنا بنتعلمه. المناهج بتاعتنا حلوة وطريقة التعليم كويسة، واحنا بس محتاجين نأقلم نفسنا ونبدأ نغير الريتم بتاعنا، بدل بقى الحفظ والصم والكلام ده كله، ان احنا ننتقل للموضوع ان احنا نبدأ نتعامل بالفهم، ونبدأ ناخد المعلومة ونبدأ نوظفها توظيف صحيح، ونجاوب على الأسئلة بشكل جيد وبشكل مناسب ان شاء الله بإذن الله. المنهج بتاعنا شابتر 1 بنتكلم فيه الفيرست بارت، chemistry is a central science. Chemistry related to different branches of science. Chemistry related to the bio. Chemistry related to the physics. Chemistry related to the agriculture, medicine and pharmacy, and future science. What is the relation between chemistry and bio? Biology studies the structure of living organisms. Chemistry explains what happens inside the living organisms. As digestion, respiration, photosynthesis process. This is some chemical reactions takes place inside living organisms. What is the relation between chemistry and physics? Physics, measurement, energy, matter, changes of matter. Chemistry help physics to study the properties of matter, which we can use for making measuring tools to get and accurate results. What is the relation between chemistry and agriculture? Agriculture in modern countries depend on chemical analysis for the soil, which help us the information about the soil, its components, what the type of fertilizer need, what is the suitable type of plant which we can cultivate in this soil to give large amount of crops. Chemistry and medicine. Doctor ask us to make a chemical analysis. Chemical analysis show the defects in hormones in our bodies. It help doctor to describe a suitable medicine for treatment of diseases and defects, and help us to get the healing properties of these substances. Modern, we get these medicines from the natural sources which have healing properties. Chemistry and modern science, our future, as nanotechnology. Nanotechnology we see around us, it help us in different fields. It help us in communication, in satellites, in tools for medicine. So nanotechnology is very, very important in our daily life. To know what's meant by nanotechnology, nanotechnology, one of the measurements. To study this measurement, this skill will help us to study the measurement. Put in this square any unit you use. This unit we have smaller than it, milli, micro, or nano. What is the relation between them? If we put in unit meter, millimeter, micrometer, or nanometer. To change meter into millimeter, times 10 power 3. From milli to micro, times 10 power 3. From micro to nano, times 10 power 3. If we want to change from meter to milli, times 10 power 3. From meter to micro, times 10 power 6. From meter to nano, times 10 power 9. If we know what is the value of nano from meter, nano times 10 power negative 9. Micro, 10 power negative 6. Milli, 10 power negative 3. How we can use this scale for change or conversion of some problems? First one. 15.7 مللتر. We want answer by nanoliter. From milli to nano. We must change from milli to nano times 10 power 6. 15.7 times 10 power 6. Change from milli to nano. From milli to nano. Meter to millimeter. Meter to millimeter. Times 10 power 3. 0.398 times 10 power 3. From second to nanosecond. From second to nanosecond. Times 10 power 9. 0.03 times 10 power 9. Meter to kilometer. Kilometer include 1000 meter. 1.445 times 10 power negative 3. Meter to kilometer. Nanometer to micrometer. This symbol is micrometer. Nano to micro. We will return one step. 903.3 times 10 power negative 3. This is the conversion. You can put this scale in front of you and use it for conversion from unit to another. It is very, very easily, and it is very, very important for you to use it in calculation. This calculation is very important. So nano equal from meter. Nano is a measuring unit. Equal 10 power negative 9 from meter. From measurement. Measurement, we studied it in physics. It is the comparison between unknown physical quantity with known physical quantity. Any measurement need two important numerical value and international measuring unit. 3 meter. 3 kilometers. 5 kilometers. Numerical value and international measuring unit. We have measuring tools used in labs as beakers, flask, pipette, pipette. And from the important type of measurement, pH value. What's meant by pH value? pH, concentration of positive ion of hydrogen. It shows us the type of solution according to the pH value. If the pH value equals 7, it means the solution is neutral, as pure water and some salts. If the value of pH is less than 7, it means the solution is acidic. If the value of pH is greater than 7, less than 14, it called us this solution is basic solution. Some questions tell us strong acid. To get strong acid, go near 0. 0.1, 0.2. Strong base, go near 14, 14, 13, 20, strong base. This is the pH value show the type of solution. How we can measure the pH value? We have two types and two tools for measuring pH value. First one is pH paper. We have paper, small paper. When we put it inside the solution, it will its color change according to the type of solution. This paper, its color will change. Solution A. And another one, solution B. If we put another paper, its color will change. Solution B. The third tube, the paper will change in C. We will compare between the change of color and this group of colors, each one under it, the concentration of pH. This 3, it means A, pH equal 3. 3 means this solution is acidic. B, 7, pH equal 7, it means the solution is neutral. C, the solution is 11, pH equal 11, it means basic solution. This is the first tool used for measuring the pH value and compare the color with the different colors we have. Number two, we can measure the pH value by using pH meter. pH meter help us to know the concentration of positive ion of hydrogen. From the measurement, we have nanosubstances. Nanosubstances, we can classify it according to its dimension. We can classify it into one dimension, nanosubstances with one dimension, as thin films, nanowires, and nanofibers. It's important to know the use for each one of them. Thin films used in covering metals to protect it from rusting. Nanowires used in electric circuit. Nanofibers used for filtration of water. Number two, two dimensions. We have carbon tubes, nanocarbon tubes, which have single-walled carbon tubes and different walls of carbon tubes. Carbon tubes have more hardness than steel, more conduct than copper, so we use it in different devices. Number three, three dimension, we have buckyball. Buckyball contains 60 carbon atoms. It is a hollow ball. It used to carry medicine without effect of the another tissues. And we have the nano shell. It used in treatment of cancer. This is the classification of nanosubstances according to its dimension, one dimension and three dimensions. We can study this part by using pictures in books. It will help you for understand what is the uses of this part of nanosubstances. Nanosubstances have an important role in our life because it helps us in different fields. It helps us in medical field, which we have robots and small devices, help us to do many diagnosis and the picturing of tissues. It used in agriculture, it used in energy field, which we use nanosilicon and produce solar cells in very, very small size, help us to get more energy. And the communication field, look your mobile. Mobile have different applications in very, very small size. Have camera, have memory, have hard, have phone, have different applications inside this device. And the environmental field for filtration of water, air by using filters. So nano help us in different branches of our life, help us by different devices. So it is modern chemistry and we use it. We have some questions for this part. We will see together. Number one, this is a picture for buckyball. Buckyball consists of 60 carbon atoms. In front of you, a table. What are the possible dimension of the opposite figure? Opposite figure is from three dimension. What's meant by three dimension? He give us length, weight, and height. Three dimension, critical nano volume, it must be less than 100. We must choose the answer number C because it have three lenses, less than 100. Length, weight, and height. So it is considered from the three dimension. But if we tell one dimension, have one less than 100. Two dimension, two less than 100. Three dimension, as we see, have three values less than 100. Question number two. Nanoparticles are characterized by their large. Nanoparticles, very, very small particles. So they have large surface area. Have large surface area. 2,751.4 gram equals answer in milligram. From gram to milligram. From gram to milligram times 10 power 3. The answer will be 2.7514 times 10 power 6 milligram. 781.2 سنتيمتر كيوبيك equal the answer 4 liter. 1 liter contain 1000 of cubic centimeter times 1000 10 power 3 0.7812. The amount of 0.398 meter equal by millimeter meter 2 millimeter times 10 power 3. What is the value of nanoliters in 15.7 milliliter? From milli to nano, 2 steps times 10 power 6. The following dimensions are of a nano ceramic particles. 3 dimensions, length, weights, and heights. This particle is a substance. It considered 40 nanometer have one dimension. One dimension nano. This graduated cylinder, the level of liquid. To read the value of volume, we must take the lower vertical reading, not from up, not from down. So this volume between 30 and 40, 535 cubic centimeter. What is the name of this tool? It called graduated cylinder. It used to measure the volume of liquids and the volume of irregular bodies. It more accurate than another tools for measure the volume. This is the chapter 1 in short notes, and you can complete with solve more problems and more questions. Thank you very much.